Hello everyone and welcome to this special film about life at the space and the qualification that we offer here. My name is David Duffy, I'm the course director here, and ordinarily of course we would have welcomed you to the space, to the auditorium, to go through this presentation, but in the current circumstances we've elected to send you this film instead. The first section of the information tonight will be an actual space film made by company members just a couple of years ago that tells you more about the qualification and shows you three different pathways that you're able to take whilst you embark on your journey here at the space.
I'm George, I'm doing performing arts, specialising in acting. At the space, you're treated as a performer. We are members of a company, we work really closely together, and the things we do are things that actually happen in the creative industry. We always go the extra mile. We have a lot of contact time with directors and tutors, and the range of work we do means that you can specialise in the area you want to and get the experience and support you need. On the course, we've devised our own theatre, we've performed new writing, learned audition technique, and created physical theatre, film, and site-specific Shakespeare. All the workshops with professional performers we get are really inspiring. I travel over an hour to get here every day, and it's completely worth the journey. I know that this was the right step for me, and I've never looked back. I'm looking forward to the next stage in my training, and the space has helped me get there.
I'm Coriella, and I'm doing performing arts, specialising in dance. We do so many different shows here, and the audiences who see them always say they seem totally professional. We've covered so many different skills like musical theatre, site-specific work, physical theatre, and a brilliant full-length dance show. In the dance element of the course, we've done choreography and dance for film, the techniques of different practitioners and different styles like ballet and jazz. We've also learned about the business of the performing arts industry and skills like marketing, which is so important for real-life work. Loads of support is on hand if we need it, and we do presentations and discussions as well as written work to show our understanding. I've loved every minute and will take these skills with me and use them in my career.
I'm Lauren and I'm doing production arts as well as some acting. The space is a really friendly place to be. Everyone knows everyone and we all support each other. We gelled as a company straight away. Across the course, I've done lighting and sound design, and also stage management with the technical theatre department, as well as film production and acting too. I have loved making my own films, and I'm going on to train further in that area. I love the whole process of film, like storyboarding, finding locations, scripting, and shooting and editing. I've learned so much from our tutors in production arts, and feel so proud that I've designed and lit the shows for the company. We are a great team and completely rely on each other. We have amazing facilities with our own auditorium at the space and at the brilliant Tacky Morris Arts Centre. We're really lucky to get the experience of working in both theatres.
I'm really proud to be a part of the space.
And it's lovely that we're still in touch with George, Coriella and Lauren as they embark on their careers, as we are with the vast majority of the young people that have come through our doors. So firstly, I'm going to talk about the company ethos that we have here at the space, which is one of our most important aspects. So we see the young people that are with us as a company and ourselves as the teaching team, as directors, choreographers, technicians, as a professional environment. So everything we do replicates the industry, and that's in the professional working practices that we use and in terms of experience of the industry to give them the best possible chance of going into the industry if that's what they want to do. Others decide not to go into the industry, but to transfer their skills into other areas. And we have many, many success stories. I can talk more about those later in the presentation. So to talk a bit more about the course, we offer the Level 3 University Arts London Extended Diploma in Performing and Production Arts. The beauty of this is that you can it's quite a flexible course, so it allows you to incorporate different skills in performance. And if you wish to, in production arts such as lighting, sound, costume, makeup, set, all of the things that go into creating a production and creating that artistic product. And that's split into three main sections. The majority of that is principal learning, which is the larger scale major productions we do here at the space. And that takes about 2/3 of the timetable. So skills, like I say, in dance and drama, musical theatre and song also, physical theatre, film production incorporated into that, and production skills. And it's the young person's, the company members' own choice whether they want to be assessed just on their performance or in those other skills, either just production arts, just performance, or to incorporate both. Then they're also able to find a specialism. So for a third of the time, those that choose performance will choose between acting or dance, and they'll work with an acting specialist or a dance specialist in a studio environment to really hone and develop their skills in those specific areas. So for example, in acting, they'll develop devising skills, working with contemporary scripts, auditions for actors, and film and television acting. And for dance, they'll be working on choreography and different dance styles such as jazz, ballet, and tap. The extended project is another element of the course, which is optional and takes place in the second year. This is worth half an A-level in itself, where the company member self-assigns a question that interests them. So it could be a specific area of performance that they found most success in or most enjoyment from. And they explore the answer to their question in a 3,000-word portfolio and a practical performance. You'll be aware that the creative industry is quite a competitive one. It's also one of the fastest industries in the UK. It incorporated with leisure also. And if you look at internet providers like Netflix and Amazon Prime that are actually creating their own artistic work, which is an area of the industry that never existed before. So it is reassuring that as technology develops, then opportunities are sort of being created also. And there's just a graphic here explaining how many creative jobs there are in the UK. But we're aware that it is a competitive industry, so we give our young people every possible experience we can to set them apart from the rest. And that often is giving them extra experience in different performance styles and in the nuts and bolts of a creative product on and off stage, so that they have the experience and the knowledge of how it's put together. So just in a nutshell then, to look at this graphic, will show you the different skills that you're able to explore here at the space in drama, dance, in film and media production, musical theatre and song, and in production arts and production support. Workshops with professional practitioners is a part of our course that's very important. We're really lucky to have a very close working relationship with the Tacky Morris Arts Centre, a public arts centre just on our doorstep. And they have a calendar of professional events throughout the year, and they bring professional companies to perform work here. So it's great that we have the opportunity to work with those companies during the daytime, to do workshops and to have Q&As and to talk to them about where they trained, what the pieces that they're showing, and we subsidise tickets to watch those certain shows at the Tacky Morris Arts Centre. So this is now a series of photographs that shows you a little bit about the experiences that you'll have here as a company member at the space. Ignition is the first performance that you'll do. The first half will be pieces of scripted acting, so contemporary texts. Also, there'll be choreography for those who like to specialise in dance. Then together, the cast and the audience come together for the second half for an extract of musical theatre. And this particular photograph was taken from Wicked that we did last year. The next project they'll embark on is the devised physical verbatim project. So this is a work that we create unique to us and our company. It's using physical theatre, so the relationship between performers and what this can tell an audience and can communicate in different ideas and themes. And there'll be a dance specialist and an acting specialist team teaching and working with the group simultaneously to be able to create a piece of physical theatre. And it's verbatim, meaning that every word in the production was spoken in real life. So it's taken word from word from transcripts or recordings. This particular photograph was taken from Fashion Conscious, which was a production that explored the life of Vivienne Westwood, who is a punk icon and activist. So we created a piece of theatre to explore her life and her ideas. We then have the Theatre in Education tour. So we cover over 20 schools in Somerset each year. The company members in small groups will have created a piece of theatre incorporating dance or scripted drama to take to young pupils, either early years or year 5 and 6. On a particular theme, and we travel around the county presenting that work to those different young people and exploring the ideas in that piece in workshops also. We have quite a lot of film experience here at the space. We work very closely with Somerset Film, based at the Engine Room, to create short films each year. And the company members are able to explore filmmaking skills and editing, as well as performing for the camera in dance or in acting. The musical is a highlight for some people as part of the course. This will be performed at the Tacky Morris Arts Centre over 5 different shows on different nights, and they're using a professional set, a professional live band and musical director that comes to work with our company. And it's an all singing, all dancing extravaganza. The photographs you can see there, last year we did Chicago. A couple of years ago was Spamalot, the Monty Python musical. And next year we're presenting Sister Act. That was due to happen in July, but has been postponed due to COVID-19. So we're hoping for that to happen in the new year. To look at some further experiences then in year two, there's a site-specific Shakespeare project. So this is creating a piece of physical theatre based on a Shakespeare text that will happen in an environment that's never had theatre happen there before. So the photograph you can look at just here is taken at Breen Down, which is a military fort on the edge of a cliff near Burnham-on-Sea. And we created Macbeth there. No electricity, and it was lit by fire. So with burning torches, braziers and campfires, quite a magical experience for everybody involved, the audience certainly no exception to that. Then we have Space Fest, which is a contemporary performance festival happening in the winter each year as part of the Year 2 programme. You can see a photograph there from the Dance Edition, which is a full-length dance show that explored everything to do with the newspaper. You can see a slide taken from Amelia, which was a contemporary play giving a voice to a 12th century poet. The dinosaur is taken from the play Enron, which had velociraptors, motorbikes, barbershop quartets, all sorts of weird and wonderful surprises. The last photograph there is an example of an extended project. These students were exploring actor musicianship, so the relationship between their ability to play a musical instrument or to sing and to use their drama skills, and they created a piece that explored both those skills based on fairy tales. And that's just one example of an extended project. Just to look at those particular individuals in that photograph, Beth, who's playing the violin, is touring the world on cruise ships and working in the leisure industry. Stephen, who's playing the guitar, worked on aerial skills after he left us here at the space and has toured internationally using those skills, including with Diversity in the O2 Arena. And Jiv behind trained as a teacher and has nursing experience also. Just a little bit about our results. We're very pleased to say that our results have been consistently outstanding year on year, putting us in the top 10% of providers of this particular course across the country. Our standards are very high, and that's because we work incredibly hard to make sure that each young person that studies with us reaches their potential and has pride in their work. And that, from what I was saying at the very start about us having a company ethos, really lends itself to that success, because they have pride in their work. We approach everything with professionalism, and as they approach their part in our pieces with professionalism also, they're able to achieve some great things. This slide looks at our alumni, just some examples of where some of the young people that have studied with us have gone on to do. So we have people who've been very successful in acting, in dance, in teaching, in technical theatre. There's one example there of a young person who has become store manager at Sainsbury's in Chard. So just one example that to show the transferable nature of the skills of the course here that we offer at the space, and how it's able to open many doors for many different people. So in the final section of the film, we'll be explaining about some of the information that's been sent out to you, either in the post or via email, and just need to cover some of those points to explain them in a little more detail. So for enrolment day at the start of term in September, we're hoping that we'll be able to open in September as normal. That's we have every intention to do that. If not, we'll be in touch via email to let you know more information. We'll also be emailing you with a slot in which to a window for you to come to enrol here at the space and to cover the necessary paperwork. This will allow us to maintain social distancing far more easily if we haven't got a rush of lots of people at once. So we'll be contacting you with more details about what your particular time slot is, but it will be between the times of 10 a.m. and 12 noon on that day. You'll need to pay the deposit, which is £150, which is £100 of which is returnable at the completion of the course. this just makes sure that if any items are lost or damaged, that we have the finances to be able to cover that loss or damage incurred by one of our young people. You'll also need to provide your GCSE results or equivalent results at level two. On enrolment day, you'll bring paper documents of your GCSE or level two results. We'll make a copy of those and give you the originals back. This is not because it's a prerequisite to your place here at the space, but just that we keep them on record. Also, it will help us to ascertain whether you need to continue study in maths and English, lessons for which happen once a week here at the space as part of your timetable earlier in the morning on a Tuesday or a Thursday. Allow us to book you a place in those particular classes, and you'll be able to resit either maths or English at our centre in due course. There is space clothing available. I'm wearing some at the moment, t-shirts, hoodies, fleeces, all sorts of different garments, vests. These are not mandatory. We do ask that you wear blacks to do any practical work, so rehearsal sessions, sometimes performances and public events. It doesn't have to be space branded clothing by any means, and there are clothing companies that sell very reasonable plain black performance wear. As I say, space clothing is available. There's details in your pack about the prices for each of those, and we have some examples here at the space if you want some more information about sizes. Not very much specialist equipment is needed to study here at the space. We ask that you have some way of hydrating yourself, so a reusable flask or bottle with water on each day. You must have pens, pencils, rulers. There is a stationery pack available from us at a cost of £3.50 if you want to buy stationery from us. If a company member requires medication, there's details in the pack regarding the way that needs to be stored, and that you have sufficient medication available for college hours, and that you inform us as a teaching team and staff. Anticipated costs. Apart from the initial deposit and any space clothing that you may require to buy, the only costs may be incurred during the 2 year period that you're with us related to excursions, workshops and clothing for specific shows. We'll endeavour to give you as much notice as possible regarding these costs, and where necessary, a payment schedule can be organised. Just a word on absence or any planned absences at the space. We do require you to be here all day, every day during the working week from 9:15 in the morning till 3:30 in the afternoon, unless those hours are extended for any reason, such as a technical rehearsal, a dress rehearsal, a performance, or watching a live show with us. And if for any reason you need to be absent due to ill health, then please do ring us before 9 o'clock in the morning. The phone number for Julia as the space administrator is in the pack. For you to ring her and explain why you won't be in for that particular day. Otherwise, we'll make calls to you to find out where you are. The difference with the space is that we work together all day, every day. So if you miss a whole day of your learning experience here at the space, then it can make quite a difference to your work and the other people around you. So we would ask that you endeavour to be here as much as possible. That it might be that you feel, if you have a slight cold or a headache, that maybe you need to watch the session rather than participate in it, and just explaining that to whoever's leading it. That would be completely understandable, but you will miss quite a lot if you're away for a substantial period of time, so just trying to avoid that whenever you can. Obviously sometimes that's unavoidable, but things like driving lessons and dentist appointments and doctor's appointments should be arranged outside of college hours if at all possible. In the pack there is included a list of contact details should you wish to contact us about anything at all. Given the current pandemic situation, it's difficult to invite you here to the space face to face, but please do keep contact via email or telephone if you have any questions or concerns or worries about starting. We're really happy to liaise with you. And there's also numbers in that pack of different people in charge of different areas, so you may want to direct your call or email to one person in particular. But the general space inquiry email address is info@thespacesomerset.co.uk. So in addition to the pack that we will email to you electronically, there'll also be a pack in the post with an admission form, the bursary application form should you wish to apply for the bursary, the clothing order form should you wish to order any space clothing, and a pre-addressed envelope to send those pieces of paperwork back to us. Mm-hmm. Those postal documents can be sent back to us as soon as you're able to, hopefully before the end of July, with the envelope provided. They can be provided on enrolment day, but obviously the earlier better, the better in terms of making sure we're organised and that things are processed in due time. Any original centre's proof for the bursary application will be copied and returned to you. We can offer payment via BACS. Parents and carers can email Julia for more information about this. I also wanted to talk to you about an exciting creative project that you can get involved in. I'll be emailing you with a piece of music and asking you to create a video of yourself performing to it. So that could be lip syncing, dancing, using props, anything that you think might fit that particular song. And it will be edited together and shared with you as the new space company that will begin in September 2020. So that's an exciting creative project. Keep your eye on your emails for that one. Ready? Oh, said it twice now. I said do that again. That was, there was something else I was going to talk about as well. I was going to do that first of all. Also, one. Well, that complete. No, kind of wasn't. Ready? So that concludes our special video about life at the space and the qualification that we offer here. Please do email us or call us with any questions, concerns, anything you want to talk over. We are always on the end of the phone or an email and really happy to chat with you and so you know what to expect and to put any concerns at rest. But thank you very much. We really hope you stay safe and keep in touch, and we're really looking forward to welcoming you here in person in September. Thank you very much. Cool. Done.